it is nothing but a bar magnet. Okay, whatever the bar magnet shows its property, whatever the bar magnet shows its property, all was shown by this solenoid. See guys, come to the point, what I said here, it is a bar magnet. If the it is a bar magnet, do you remember that from in the bar magnet, it has a magnetic field now. Then bar magnet also have a magnetic field. Then bar magnet has a magnetic field lines. Bar magnet has a magnetic field lines. Isn't it? Where the magnetic field lines will be there? See here. Now come to the point of solenoid. Leave about the solenoid now. Now can anybody say from which direction to which direction the magnetic field lines were moved in the bar magnet?
Same here also.
We will move to the magnetic field lines. Before that, if we change this one as negative and if we change this one as positive, if we change minus as this one as negative and that one as positive, will the current flows or not flows?
Flows.
Isn't it? Will it change as a negative, negative itself, positive and positive itself? Suppose it is a north pole, it is a south pole. It is a north pole, it is a south pole. Okay, when we change its polarity, will it change as south as north, north and south? Nothing changes, it acts as same as a bar magnet itself. Isn't it? Now, come to the point, is it clear up to here? Now, I will move to the next topic. Not a next topic, in this topic only, how the magnetic field lines react for the solenoid. Okay, now, see here. For the same diagram. Guys, one more thing you remember, it's just a rough diagram I have shown you to make you understand, that's it. Okay, now, this is a north pole, this is a south pole. Here also, if it has a magnetic field means it should be a magnetic field lines also there for this. When it has a magnetic field lines, then it is nothing but a bar magnet. In a bar magnet, how the current magnetic field lines flows from north to south. Okay, in this direction moving, they are in the form of concentric circle loops. These magnetic field lines are in the concentric circle loops. Isn't it? In the bar magnet also I have shown. From north to south. North to south. North to south. Like this here. It is, these magnetic field lines are outside the solenoid. Got? These magnetic field lines in the concentric circle loop are outside the solenoid. Then what about the inside the solenoid? Inside the solenoid, it is a hollow. It is in a hollow means, see, one more diagram I used to show you. Concentric circle outside the solenoid, north to south. Inside the solenoid, they are parallel to each other. When it is parallel to inside the solenoid, there also they will move from north to south itself, but in a straight line. Outside the solenoid, concentric circle of the loop. Inside the solenoid, straight line, but both are from north to south itself. When they move from north to south, which from outside the magnetic field lines have more strength or inside the magnetic field line have more strength?
Inside.
How can you say that it is a inside they have a more strength? Because, can anybody say?
Because
the lines have more. There is no more gap between the lines. It means it has more strength, it has less strength. Simple example I will give you. I will place one object here. The same object I will place here inside the solenoid. Which has more strength?
Inside.
inside. Why? Because see here, the magnetic field lines which are moving outside the solenoid have more distances. More distances is there between each other. When there is a more distances between each other, the magnetic field line passes through these substances are less. What? Magnetic field lines which are passes through this substance is less. But inside there is no gap. There are continuously flow of magnetic field lines. So this will get a more strength. When it gets a more strength, this material also starts as acting as same as magnet itself. When they allows us to pass the current, magnetic field through that, then it starts a magnetic effects from that also. This is the concept for this solenoid here. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Now, come to the points. Let me go through the points and make understand now. What is the first part of the solenoid? It is a long solid rod shaped iron wounded by a insulated copper wire in form of helix. I've shown you what is helix. Copper wire. What is, why it is took in a hollow row. Okay. And it is a soft iron. First point. Second point, what says? It is an electromagnet generates a controlled magnetic field when current passed through them. I said you, controlled magnetic field. Why? Current increases, intensity of current increases, magnetic field increases. Magnetic field increases, obviously. Magnetic field increases, obviously what increases here? Attraction and repulsion. Magnetism, everything increases. If I reduces, everything reduces. So it is under our control, second point says. Third point, it produces the same effect as it produces by a bar magnet, as I said you. It never changes its any properties. It acts as the same as a bar magnet itself. Third point, one end behaves as a north pole and another one as a south pole. One as a north pole, another one as a south pole. As we learnt in the loop of a circle or circular path, north pole anti-clockwise, south pole clockwise. That only, as I said. Okay, that wounded copper wire also acts one as clockwise, one as anti-clockwise. Okay, now. It is about the solenoid. Then what about the solenoid magnetic field and magnetic field lines? That also we have discussed just now. Now, magnetic field lines of a solenoid outside the magnetic field. Remember, outside the magnetic field starts at north and ends at south, as said. Now starts at north and ends at south. Next, concentric circle. They are in concentric circle loops.
Yes.
We got that one also from the outside. What about the inside here? Inside the solenoid, lines are parallel, I have said. Now, strength of the magnetic field is same as at all point, increases the strength. Length of the magnitude is same at all the points. Why? Because they are parallel to each other. There is no gap between the lines of the magnetic field. Next, strength field can be used to magnitude the substances. It means magnitude the substances means, as I said, I can keep the object here. It transfers the magnetism to that and it will be a magnitude substance. It will become a magnet there. Okay. What the difference is? That is, bar magnet is permanent. It is temporary. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, come to the point. As I have said, where, why we will use only the soft iron? Why can't we use another steel and all? Why can't we use the another substances here? Because whenever the current, what I said here, whenever the intensity of current is starts for this, it acts as a magnet. When the current intensity of current stops, it stops acting as a magnet. Only the soft iron can do this. But remaining substances as steel and all we took, when the current starts, it starts as a magnet itself. Everything is same. But when you turn off the flowing of current or intensity of current, you turn off. But also for few minutes or temporarily it start acting as magnet itself. So why we will use this soft iron? You got?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to you?
Yes,
now come to the point where these solenoids are used. Why this solenoid is useful? Only one example I will give you. Can I get that? Only one example I will give you. These solenoids methods, I mean this magnetism is used for the Malgave trains. Do you know Malgave trains?
No, sir.
Magnitude trains. It's not there in India. Only in Japan we can, in foreign countries we can see. Isn't it?
Yes.
What is that? Malgave trains, there they will use the same project here. How they will use? Simple example I will give you. This is a solenoid. At least in a pictures or in a videos you might have saw. It will be a distance this much. This much distance will be there from this part, this solenoid. Isn't it? Why that train? How that train can be controlled? See here, simple thing I will say you. It is under our control. It is under our control. How we increases current? Magnetic field increases. How the magnetic field increases? The attraction and repulsion increases. How the magnetic field increases? This train starts to move fast. However, if you increase the intensity of the current, the train will move faster and faster. However, you reduce the intensity of the current, train starts to become slower and slower. So, this project is used in the Malgave trains. It means magnitude trains. This is the same concept they will use for the magnitude trains. However, always that magnitude trains was controlled by this electromagnet. What is electromagnet? We will see in the next topic. Whatever the substances which acts as a magnet by the supply of a intensity or intensity of a current are known as a electromagnet. We will see that one later. Is it clear about this topic?
Yes, sir.
Did you understood what is this?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Now come to the point of the factors which affects the solenoid. Factors which affects solenoid. The factors which affects the solenoid we will see now. Factors affecting the solenoid, that means solenoid has a magnetic field. That magnetic field should be affected by current itself. Why it is? See here, first point I will take as a current. What is current here? How it will be used? Why we will take a current itself? However, the current increases, magnetic field increases. However, the magnetic field increases, everything increases. Just now I have given the example of Malgave trains. Or else you can see the previous experiment of us. However, I increases the power of this cell, means current, those nuts were attracting more, like that. So what happens? Current increases, magnetic field increases. So magnetic field is denoted by B. Magnetic field is directly proportional to, the current, not I, that is current, denoted by R. Very good. Sorry, I have forgotten that. Okay, next thing, number of turns. Magnetic field will be also depends on number of turns. How can you say in the number of turns? Magnetic field is directly proportional to N. How can you say that it is the, it also depends on the number of turns? See here. Here there are a gap between the bonded wire. When there is a gap, will it produce more magnetic field? Why it will not produce a more magnetic field? Because in this gaps, what happens? The air will come and take a place. When the air comes and take a place in this, what happens? The magnetic field will reduce its power. If they are in like this, on the number of turns are more, magnetic field strength is more, less strength is less, number of turns magnetic force. So magnetic field is also directly proportional to the number of turns, length of the solenoid, length of solenoid. What is length of solenoid here? How much length is there of solenoid? That much more power we need. That much more copper wire should be on them. So it is directly proportional or inversely proportional to the solenoid? No, it is inversely proportional. Okay. However, if we have 10 volt of current here, little copper wire, it 20 meter long solenoid, soft iron is there. How can it produce? It's impossible. So what you will get here, magnetic field is inversely proportional to the length of the conductor. These are all the equations which, these are all the factors which affects the solenoid. Is it clear about the solenoid?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
Only the thing, it acts as same as a bar magnet, but it is temporary, that is permanent. We will see in the next topics which are the permanent magnets, how they act, what are the forces, Fleming's left hand rule, and remaining AC and DC motors. Is it clear? Last topic of today's class. Okay, let's see what is electromagnet. Why we are seeing the electromagnet means, if you learned the solenoid, or if we learned what is straight wire, its shape, and circular loop and solenoid, it is very easy topic to understand, and nothing is there to explain for you. Again the same it will come. See here, electromagnet. What is electromagnet? Electromagnet is a temporary magnet which acts as a magnet and shows all the magnetic properties and shows the magnetic field only when the power is supplied. Okay, when the power is supplied and it is under our control. That magnet, that electromagnet is under our control and it is in our hand. Okay, we can control that only. Okay, next one what we will say, we can change the polarity and the direction. We can change the polarity and direction. I have shown you in the diagram how it can be changed. Okay, if positive to negative or north to south, will it change? Will it change?
No, sir.
It changes, but it's in our hand. Okay, now see here, that is electromagnet means, just you remember guys, what is electromagnet here? Electromagnet is nothing but a temporary magnet which only shows its magnetic property when there is a supply of heavy irritating agent. Get out. When it shows only the supply of current, when it only shows the intensity of current increases, everything increases. When intensity decreases, intensity of current decreases, everything decreases. See, they come to the points, very simple. A temporary magnet that shows the property of a magnet when current passes through them. I said, when current passes through them, it shows the temporary magnet. When the current stops, it doesn't show the magnet. Next, example, Malgave trains, I have said. Magnetic trains. Magnetic trains runs on the electromagnet itself. Current increases, magnetic field increases, train speed increases. To stop, power decreases, intensity of current decreases, magnetic field strength decreases, its speed decreases. Okay, this is the simple thing. Next, it's polarity can be reversed and also the direction. Its polarity can be reversed and also the direction. If the current is moving in this direction, we can change from that direction to this direction by changing the poles of the positive and negative terms. Next, it is a controlled magnetic field. I have said it is under our control. How much strength of the magnet we want, magnetic field we want, that much strength we can take, that much strength we can increase, or that much strength we can reduce. So it is all about the electromagnet. Is it clear about the electromagnet?
Yes, sir.
Only one thing is, if you understood the solenoid, nothing is there in this. Is there any difference from the solenoid and this?
Yes,
everything is same itself. Now let's see which are the factors affects the strength of the electromagnet. Okay, factors affect strength. Factors affect strength of. Sorry, factors affect strength of this electromagnet itself. I can't write more. Factors affect the strength of electromagnet. Okay. First thing, same current. What it is? What is current? Magnetic field is directly proportional to the current, as we saw in from the where?
Electricity.
No. Straight wire also, that is, this is I am saying you. All depends on the current, all depends on electromagnet, depends on the current. Increases, decreases, no need of saying you again and again. Next. What is that? Number of turns. Number of turns. What is number of turns here? How many turns? Okay, see here in this solenoid, and again I will show last. Turns are increased, magnetic field increases. So more number of turns should be there. So magnetic field line is directly proportional to number of turns. When it is directly proportional to number of turns, last but not least, gaps or distance you can take. Gaps between the wire. Copper insulated copper wire. What it is? Gaps is nothing but a distance between the bonded copper wire. So, magnetic field is inversely proportional to the distance. Okay? Is it clear to you? Now, what you will get the equation for this electromagnet? Magnetic field is proportional to current into number of turns. Okay, how much current is supplied, that much more number of turns is required. So, number of turns into current divided by distance. How much gap is there? That much. So, distance. This is the equation you will get for what?
Electromagnet.
Is it clear up to here?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts from the straight wire, circular loop, solenoid and electromagnet? Any doubts? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we will move to the next topic as a permanent magnet. Not today. In tomorrow's class. Permanent magnet. Which are the permanent magnet? Permanent magnets. Force acting on the permanent magnet and how it affects Fleming's left hand rule. All will cover tomorrow's classes. And day after tomorrow's or in the further days, AC and DC motors, it's working. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No,